On slide 5, we show the change in Trump's favorability and approval since November and May. So just as a little bit of context, so this survey went into the field and was done before the week in which all the kind of news about Comey's firing and everything else happened. So this is all Tennesseans' registered voters' approval prior to those activities. But even so, it's pretty notable, we think, that from November to May, Trump's approval in Tennessee declined from 60% to 52%. And so that was a decline. On page 6 of the presentation, you can see what happened, you know, how this kind of breaks out by partisanship. And here, not surprisingly, Democrats are not varying approval, only 10%. And Republicans, you know, 86% of Republicans approve of Trump, and 90% of Tea Party members. Whereas independents, you know, they're more closely split. 49% of independents approve of Trump's performance as president, and 42% disapprove of that performance. Relatedly, on slide 7, we asked was, you know, President Trump was elected in some sense to change politics as we knew it. And so we wanted to think about and ask what voters and registered voters in Tennessee thought about President Trump's performance and whether or not they were changing Washington for the better or not. And here again, we see pretty sizable changes in people's opinions about how Trump's performing on that metric. So in November in 2016, 54% of registered voters in Tennessee thought that Trump was going to change things for the better in Washington. In May, that number fell to only 41%. And in fact, the percentage who thought that that Trump would change things for the worst increased from 20% in November up to 31% in May. And 23% thought that that would stay the same. On slide 16, it repeats the question that we've been asking since May of last year about various options to what should be done with the health care law. And it's pretty notable to us that there's a pretty marked shift in terms of what people's views are, perhaps in response to kind of what they saw occur during the House's debate. So in particular, the percent who say the Affordable Care Act should be repealed and not replaced is at its lowest level to 14%. Moreover, the percentage that say the U.S. should have a single-payer system, is the highest level it's been at 22%. More broadly, if we think about, the two, with liberal versus support for liberal versus kind of more conservative policy options. If you look at the right, the two responses to the right, that's either building on existing health care law or changing it to establish a guaranteed universal health care coverage, it's pretty remarkable that in May, in the most recent poll, 55% of people think that either Obamacare should be improved in Tennessee or replaced with a single health universal coverage with a single payer system. And this is a marked shift. And that's increased by 11 points since November of 2016. So it seems like Tennesseans are kind of updating their beliefs about what healthcare ought to be. And perhaps in response to this, we also asked a series of questions about particular views on particular aspects that are salient to the healthcare debate and kind of which show the difficulty that Republicans face in trying to transmit their campaign promises to repeal and replace to a workable and viable alternative that will gain acceptance among the electorate. So on slide 17, we asked the question about whether or not registered voters think that health insurance companies should be able to decide whether or not to provide coverage based on a person's medical history. And here, there's widespread opposition. 80% of registered voters in Tennessee think that insurance companies should not be allowed to deny coverage based on medical history. And this is across the board bipartisan in its belief. Even 72% of registered voters who approve of Trump say that insurance companies should not be allowed to deny coverage based on medical history. And that's true for Democrats, Republicans, independents, and members of the Tea Party. Another question that we asked was a slightly weaker question, right? So that question had to deal with whether or not you could deny coverage. On slide 18, we also posed to registered voters whether or not health insurance companies should be able to charge different rates for the same benefits based on a person's medical history. And here again, 78% of registered voters in Tennessee oppose this policy. Even 72% of people who approve of the job President Trump is doing as president think that insurance companies should not be able to charge different rates for the same benefits based on a person's medical history. And that's a, you know, that's 75% of Republicans think that, 88% of Democrats, 76% of independents, even 65% of people who so-called identify with the Tea Party think that insurance companies should not be able to charge different rates based on medical history, which is, you know, a pretty, you know, notable and bipartisan support that kind of really illustrates the difficulty that Republicans have in kind of, you know, reforming healthcare system. Slide 19 asks about, you know, allowing young adults to stay on their parents' healthcare plans until age 26. Again, not surprisingly, given the prior results, there's wide and bipartisan agreement on whether or not this should be still required. 79% of people overall, doesn't matter what their partisanship is, doesn't matter whether they approve of Trump or not. Everybody in Tennessee, nearly 80%, think that, you know, dependents should be able to stay on their parents' health care coverage. And then the final question that we asked about specific health care policy on slide 20 was whether or not health insurance companies providing coverage for treatment services for alcohol and drug addiction should be covered. And again, 78% of registered voters in Tennessee think that, you know, addiction treatment services should be covered under health care. And that's true, again, we're bipartisan, slightly higher among Democrats, 86%. But, you know, 72% of people approve of Trump, 72% of Tea Party, 77% independents, and even 74% of Republicans all think that health insurance coverage should cover, you know, addiction treatment. So those kind of put some more nuance about what Tennesseans are thinking about, and they help explain the difficulty that Republicans face in trying to reform healthcare system in the state and also nationally.
Slide 23 is a new question, and it's been an issue that's confronted the state legislature the last couple of sessions about whether the children of undocumented immigrants should have access to in-state tuition. And we haven't asked this question before, but we wanted to see where the public stands. And as you can see, 66% of Tennesseans believe that the children of undocumented immigrants, those students who have attended Tennessee high schools, now have a chance to go to Tennessee public college. They want them to have access to in-state tuition. And this is a big number, 66%. And it's true, the next slide, where you go to slide 24, it doesn't matter that much about party. That is that even 55% of Republicans think that's a good thing to do. Obviously, Democrats are more in support of it. Independents very much in support of it. And even among the Tea Party, it's basically split 50-50. So it's fair to say that this is an issue that has broad support across the state, allowing the children of these undocumented immigrants access to our universities, public universities and colleges. Slide 25, we continue to talk about education and asking about and thinking about higher education, whether you support or oppose state-funded scholarships that will allow all Tennessee adults to attend a community college tuition-free. This is one of the centerpieces of Governor Haslam's policy agenda. And again, it's something that has quite a bit of support. You've got 56% strongly supporting it, which is a very sizable number. And you add that to the 27% that somewhat support, you know, we just have a small handful, about 15%, that either oppose or strongly oppose this particular move. So lots of support for that. And again, if you break it out by party, which we do in slide 26, Republicans are supportive. Obviously, Democrats, only 3% of Democrats are in favor of the program. But again, you know, over nearly 80% of Tea Partiers favor this program. I mean, widespread support for this initiative.